wrong with this patch as his brewmaster? At least not yet.
Yes. Right. You think brew is more of an issue?
No, I don't.
No, you think
I think that they need to draft against it as opposed to ban it.
Yes.
Because they just did not.
They didn't have the tools before. No. Yeah. I mean, so what do you draft to deal with it?
I think Disruptor. AA would have been pretty good. They banned it out themselves.
Yeah.
Though.
Alliance.
Okay, so that kind of opened it up for a more comfortable pickup for Alliance because the AA was banned.
More importantly, Elder Titan, which OG first picks. Why is no one else using it? Especially they pick it when it's not.
You say that, but one thing you got to remember that AA Ice Blast, it doesn't stop the Sunder.
It's still like good at bursting him down. Like, I guess. That plus AA plus Zeus, for example, I think is really good at just killing him. Yeah. Or with a Tinker, just so Alliances you can't save him, especially if there's like a Grave on his team.
Yeah.
But, it's
going
to
be the Brew thing coming out. We saw this earlier from S4. Mm-hmm. We saw it twice. Both games against Fnatic did win them both. It's another kind of Alliance staple that they've been having a lot of fun with so far today in the Terrorblade. Bam, Vega. Bit of a respect there for Loda. It's going to take it straight
10
out.
10 seconds remaining.
Yep. There's not that many Orchid
Five
carriers nowadays,
remaining.
Which I think is one of Brew's biggest weakness, which is instant silence. Anything with a cast point is
Reserve
generally going to be too slow to deal with a blink clapping ulting Brew. But if you have an instant cast point like Orchid, Lion Hex is pretty good. Anything like that
Alliances
that can stop him from ulting, you will win a team fight and force him to get BKB very early on. So, what are the Orchid carriers? Quaswex Invoker, Quap, and Storm come to mind. So I would like to see teams explore this solution, as a deal with the Brewmaster.
5 seconds remaining.
Fourth ban here from Alliance. See what they want to take away from Vega. You said themselves Vega will like to maybe play a bit better in the early stages, look to secure that's part of the game, get a bit more action going. Alliance so far, they've certainly banned a lot of the heroes that would be great for them. And there's another hero that could really get the ball rolling for Vega. Nightstalker taken away. So Alliance respecting that. And Nightstalker, I guess, as well. Just a hero that's incredible. I mean, already, against a Dazzler and a Brewmaster, Crippling Fear, that's just a nuisance to play against.
It really is.
Because, yeah. I mean, you can just make a beeline for the Dazzler, and there's nothing you can do to stop
him,
really.
10 seconds remaining.
I'm surprised being Coddle. I'm not sure what the Coddle ban is about.
5 seconds remaining.
The Lycan definitely makes sense. Darkseer plus Lycan is just absolute misery for any support out there. So Vega have already a potent combo. Probably need a little bit more damage to dump into that, as well as a good Ion Shell carrier. I think Ember Spear is really good at dealing with Brewmaster. He has like decent burst, but he doesn't have to commit to a fight. Don't want to commit to a fight versus Brewmaster. You want him to commit his ultimate and then just peace out. Like Stampede used to be picked very often, like while he was splitting. Ember, Weaver, these heroes that can just like threaten a Brew, but back out if Brew actually commits suicide.
Alliances. It is, of course, that age-old counter to the Dazzle. Bit of control, of course, against the Brew as well. But picking about third, Alliance Tilt, they have three picks to pick around this Axe.
I think it's still a great pick, regardless. The only problem is that the laning is, I think, is fairly obvious for the Axe, because Darkseer is most likely going to be offlane, and then Axe is either going to be...
Oh yeah, where are you playing the Axe? Is it just
likely
jungle?
Or safe lane. But if you put a safe lane, you have scaling issues. If you put it in the jungle, you have laning issues. So Alliance can identify that very early on.
Unless it's kind of Axe, Darkseer, bottom lane, dual lane.
That's, I think, pretty weak, because both of them
got the creep waves, you know, really punish Loda.
You need levels, though.
I guess.
You just sack the lane with, like, a... Like, let's say Weaver. Weaver would be great down there.
Yeah, who doesn't care about the way that the Axe Darkseer would run.
You're okay with getting sacked. Yeah. It's, like, not a big deal. Okay. Slark, I think, is sometimes gets sacked, although I don't like it as much versus that lineup. But I also think it's just like way too risky. Those two heroes can get underleveled, and then you can just swoop in. They're still their offlaner, too. You can just, like, get an NP on offlane, just absolutely own those two. So...
I mean, the load of lifesteal has been left in. This is something that's obviously been prioritized in bans before, but this game obviously opted for a Terrorblade ban. There is a lifesteal that's still available in a game where I guess the Axe can still work pretty nicely against the lifestealer, but a Disruptor, of course, it's lovely to have that. And also, if you're laning against a Darkseer, lifesteal is pretty good at that, or is it not necessarily the pick the Alliance would look for it?
It's great for Starkseer.
Yeah. see what Vega want to take up here now.
I'm not sure it's particularly good versus Axe. It kind of works both ways.
Okay.
Like, Axe with blade mail has a lot of armor, yeah. Berserker's Call, but it's just really hard to kill Lifesteal. He's very rarely going to get in critical range, and he's going to feast a lot of damage onto the Axe, so that's kind of a wash. But versus Darkseer,
reserve time.
You know, pretty good. Very good versus Disruptor. I think Jug is pretty good, because I like the mix of damage versus the Axe. Magical and physical.
Here we are, fourth pick for Vega. Start to reveal a little bit more of their plans in terms of where they do want to place this Axe this game.
I really would like an Ember from them.
We didn't really talk about it, but is there a chance they put the Axe mid against the Brew?
Yeah, that's actually a very good point that you make, that teams used to run as a counter towards Brew when Brew was like mega popular, but is that no one's type of hero?
Because I imagine with that Bane pick as well, Alliance may be anticipating the Axe is going to be mid. I guess what now? There we have it revealed. It's not going to be a mid Axe. It is going to be DP in the mid lane. But then, nonetheless, normally when the Bane is picked up by Alliance, it normally kind of sits around the mid, doesn't it, at the start to help secure us for that early start. I mean, this is exactly how we saw them play earlier today. They're going to pick up the Brood. Again, I think I want to say this is pretty much the same draft that we saw from them this morning. This is pretty much classic Alliance.
I think Vega's lineup is really good at dealing with Brood. Darkseer and Axe are just like incredibly good.
You got the catch, you got the counter. Yeah.
I don't know if they want to put Axe in the safe lane though. Maybe they could do like, I'm trying to think of any other lane possibilities they can do. Because if you do Axe safe lane, then that means that Darkseer would have to go off lane or jungle, and your carries would be very vulnerable.
Reserve time.
So, they can't really aggro because Disruptor is terrible at aggro, and Axe is not a support in that sense. He needs levels in jungle, so they might still pick another hero that is good at dealing with Broodmother, let's say.
Okay. Something else, yeah.
I like LC. LC, I think, is very good versus the Bane.
LC got a bit of a buff as well, didn't she?
Yep, she did.
What was it?
10 seconds.
Overwhelming
remaining.
Odds, I believe. Yep. That does extra damage per unit or something.
Yep, it does more damage such. Now.
It was at like plus 20 per each level, so it was quite significant.
I also think it's good because it protects Death Prophet.
Yeah.
We always talk about defensive spells for Death Prophet. Press the attack is exceptional.
That's true. I guess at the moment, all they've really got is the Surge to help DP, but that is it. Final ban from Vega Squadron. It's going to be a bit of a respect against a Wars Loader, taking away the Naga. They don't want to go against the TB, they don't want to go against the Naga. Take those both away.
It could be AM.
Loader anti-mage.
Could be. Very good versus Darkseer.
I triple intel lineup.
I think it's pretty good versus Death Prophet as well. But then they have this like kind of weird lineup where you have a Broodmother and an Anti-Mage and then a Brewmaster. Like two heroes want to split push, one hero wants to fight. So I would suppose that they almost always outscale with the Broodmother. So it's definitely going to be something that like isn't all any, but something that farms a lot and does well versus Darkseer. Lifestealer, I suppose, would be just fine.
Yeah, Lifestealer. I guess. Okay, Sven Banner.
Alliances.
Well, what about the Juggernaut this game?
Juggernaut's okay. Yeah. It just hasn't been their flavor, rather.
Oh, maybe they bring something a bit different again here, Alliance.
I do like the magic immunity versus the Disruptor. I think
that's
very
always
important to have.
That's always something that you got to think about, isn't it? And I think it's something that Vega Squadron would have banned out if they didn't feel too scared of the kind of the Naga Terrorblade long game that Alliance like to play for.
They could also do
Gyrocopter. Now that's
a nice mix of team fight.
Okay.
With the Bruins Gyrocopter, they actually have a pretty good team fight.
It's great with Dazzle Gyro. Hit a good weave and start getting the flat cannon hits out. The backliners just start to drop like flies.
It is. It's a good BKB hero. You need the magic immunity versus Disruptor Darkseer.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, but I mean, it's definitely not the go-to carry for a lot of teams. Remaining.
It isn't, but
in this patch,
Brewmaster, you have four heroes that want to fight with Broodmother. If you have like three and two, you kind of just waste your Brewmaster because Brewmaster's going to constantly be looking for fights.
I like what Vega's going to take the Lifesteal themselves. I mean, this is a hero that does not care about Gyrocopter in the early kind of fighting stages of the game. Surely he just rages, runs at him, starts to chomp for him.
But he has a lane versus Brood.
Is that how the lane's going to go down? Do you think you are going to get that matchup? Or do you try and position the Axe against the Brood lane?
Do you want
to
do...
Or is it just going to be Axe jungle, as you said? You don't think Axe is going to go to the off lane with Darkseer?
I think it's going to be Axe jungle, yep. Darkseer safe lane, and Lifestealer Disruptor off. That makes the most sense. Because if Bane hangs around mid, then Lifestealer can get some farm on bottom. It's kind of like newbie style.
Yeah.
How they run it. But Lifestealer is not a good matchup for Brood at all. So I think you want to avoid that lane at all costs. And Alliance rarely pull the switcheroo, which is the Broodmother in a safe lane. So we'll see if what they have up their sleeve.
10 seconds remaining.
I will indeed, as we get this one on. Second game in, Vega versus Alliance here in the upper bracket of the group stages. And here we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see if Alliance are going to be able to take this one a clean 2-0, or if Vega will be able to swing it back around with a very much a different draft to what they showed earlier in game one. And we'll go for the lineups on the side of Alliance. We've got Loda playing the Gyrocopter. Bulldog's going to be on that off lane. Broodmother EGM on his Bane. S4 on his signature Brewmaster. And finally, last but not least, Ake on, again, pretty much the Dazzle, which we've seen a lot of great plays, great saves from the man. Over on the side of Vega, top we've got Solo at the moment. He's going to be joined up with the forces of FN on that live stealer. So we'll see how much Solo wants to put towards the jungle, and if they're able to get away with that kind of greedier laning play cell. No one on the mid lane on the Death Prophet. Bottom lane, Storm of the Slayers hanging around with Mag, but it looks like indeed it will just be Mag on his own down here for the time being. Here we have it as we get this set up and the lanes into place.
30 seconds to battle.
I mean, Ben, lane-wise, who's winning the lanes here? You said Vega, you'd like to see them try and put a bit more emphasis on the earlier laning stage and getting the earlier action going. Do they have the tools to do so this game?
If they get the right lane matchup.
Yeah.
So it looks like FN is going to be jungling. Did he talk about that?
Oh, was FN?
He has an Iron Talon.
Oh. Okay. And we'll put Solo in the safe lane.
Yeah, I like this.
So why are you doing this?
Why? Lifestealer is terrible versus Brood.
Okay.
And yeah. X owns Brood.
Yeah,
X owns Brood.
Yeah.
I was thinking, I've seen some Brood beat X, but it was only with a 0-4-4.
Where you just go straight in with the passing of the Lifestealer.
Yep.
Okay.
But they will not dodge. Alliance will not. And Vega.
The battle begins.
I think this is a smart lane rotation thing, though. Lifestealer is fine at jungling. Especially if you don't have supports that can rotate. But the problem is they do have one that can kind of rotate, which is the EGM Bane.
Yeah, EGM can certainly be a nuisance. He loves playing his Bane.
Yep, and they do have that Observer Ward that will scout out a jungle Lifestealer, although maybe not as deep as the Alliance would have hoped. And four-man mid.
All right, Disruptor and DP against the Brew and the Bane. Who's coming out on top here?
Two range heroes should be one range hero.
It's good mass, Ben.
Mm-hmm.
The stats do not lie in this case. One thing this is going to mean, though, is Mag at the moment. Okay, he's just clearing out this camp. It's a smart thing to do. Make sure he does get that level 2 before coming down.
He's
into
versus Dazzle. Dazzle should not be able to zone out a Darkseer.
Those are kind of what two over safe play here from Mag. He doesn't.
Darkseer fell off a lot because Darkseer got a lot more popular.
Okay.
Because Darkseer has a lot of armor. 6 base armor versus the physical damage from the poison touch from Dazzle. Most of the zoners have, like Bane, for example, has pure damage on his brain set. What is that? I really think they were going to kill there.
Wow, they tried for it.
They tried for it. But yeah, with the Dazzle, you can't zone him out with poison touch. He has so much armor and regen that he just tanks it straight up. But yeah, I think Mag may be a little bit too conservative with this play here. He is known for being pretty stable, which is not dying, but if you need to take risk if you want to get your farm up. And his Blink Dagger last game came way too late because maybe he was a little bit too safe. So, you know, I think a lot of the offlaners nowadays take risk. I don't know. At the same time, like, Universe is known for his very safe and stable play and is used to work out for his teams. So, two different philosophies on that.
I mean, if anything, though, this is... I mean, we talked about how well Loda's going to be able to turn up to these earlier fights and drop his combo. Just the fact that he's going to have this kind of start, that's going to put the Gyro in a great place. This is, you know, great news for Alliance that the Loda's going to be able to get this free farm for the time being. Mag's now come into the lane. We'll see how much he's able to do to disrupt the Gyro's farm, but Loda should be able to play around with his range and still find the farm that he needs to in this bottom lane.
Now look at this Dazzle, just able to stack up these camps, deny like a full creep wave because the Darkseer's not there. And it's a big deal. Imagine if they had warded up this camp, what would he do? Go all the way to the jungle, have to share it with a Lifestealer? Like, I don't know. I'm just generally not a fan of this this offlaner play, at least in this patch. In other patches, maybe an EGM with that Arcane Rune, getting some value out of that Brain Sap.
We can see at the moment as well in the mid lane to 2v2 matchup. Indeed, as you said, two range seeming to be 1. It's 9-1 against 5-2. So
you like that maths?
It's working out. No one on the Death Prophet. It's certainly with a slight lead. It's still close. Looking towards the top lane as well, Bulldog, he seems to be having a fine old time so far. 11 CS, Axe is certainly winning the lane, but Bulldog by no means is in any danger of dying. He's doing fine against this Axe. He's managing to get involved in these side pulls. He's getting more than enough experience. It's just going to be all interesting to see how FN turns up to the fight after starting off here in the jungle, and how much he can get done when he starts to run into the side of Alliance. I guess it's relying on Solo to pick up the Blink Dagger. But I guess the question being, does this Axe get the Blink Dagger first, or would you expect to just see a Vanguard come out?
Depends on how long you want to stay in the lane versus the Brood. If you want to stay in the lane a long time versus Brood, you get Vanguard. If you want to gank early, you get the Blink. This game, there's kind of merits both ways, because he does have the Infest Bomb, and he's also incredibly strong with Ion Shell and Berserker's Call. But you don't want the Brood to get out of control. And you can kill him much easier with the Blink Dagger. I don't know.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
There's kind of varying philosophy on that, too.
Top lane. Actually, has Ake coming in. Maybe looking to see if they can get a heal bomb off onto the Axe. So they can make this play, surrounding him with the spiders. There we go. Not maybe quite the amount of damage they hope for. Well, with the cool, and Bulldog's got to be careful. Another spin might have just done it. Looking to position the spiders again. Another heal bomb available in a second. They'll try and get the positioning right. There's your heal bomb, and Alliance, they've done it. Beautiful play from Ake and Bulldog. The spider bomb combination there, doing it against the Axe. And Bulldog getting first blood in this lane that was indeed on paper going to be a tough one for him, thanks to the presence of Ake.
Yeah, that was great play from Bulldog. On top of that, Bulldog microed his spiderlings very well. And a big mistake by the Axe by not carrying a TP scroll. You always want a TP scroll for Sip Brood matchup. Because at level 6, sometimes if you get unlucky with spins, he can just run you down with the incapacitating bite. But in this particular game, that's going to set him back a lot.
I mean, I guess the question is, does Ake try for that again? He's walking back to base to refuel on the mana front. Does he just go up top and do they attempt to go for the heal pawn once more and try and get another bit of a kill?
He can disrupt the lane, then why not?
Yeah.
It's not like he's going to really do that much good in the mid lane. Actually, S4, S4's not 6 yet, so not really any play there. He can't stop a Dark
Here it comes.
Away, so
Ake says, oh, this is great fun. Let's try and do it again, Bulldog. And Solo, of course, he TP'd into lane.
And he is going for Vanguard. Which I think is fine, considering he needed it right before he died.
One heal bomb. Start to get the slowdown. Try and position yourself for a second one. This time might be a little bit harder. Did lose a fair few spiders. But Ake, you've been rumbled. The show's over. You're not getting away with it again. And Solo dunks down on what will be a very satisfying kill for him, as they will punish Ake for trying to go for the same play. They're not going to fall foul to that one twice, Vega.
And they pass the dust. Lifesteal had dust. He passed it on to the Axe. And yeah, that was also a really smart play by Solo. Last time he used his call too early because the Broodlings split off, and he didn't use his call, so he doesn't have the damage from the Spiderlings, which is a significant source of damage once the call is down.
Mid lane. I know that we haven't been looking out for a bit of time.
That's kind of just one of those wash lanes, but he was farm a lot.
S4 still getting there slowly, but surely no one still does maintain.
Both their CSs are actually quite terrible, though. But that's kind of the 2-on-2 nature of the mid lane. They're half the CS of the safe laners.
Yeah. I mean, Loda, Jarrett picked up the lifesteal as well, so the self-sustaining lane is going to be fine. Mag on his Darkseer again. He's been back and forth between the lane and the side camp. Halfway through level 7, so certainly finding the levels and actually keeping himself ahead of Bulldog in terms of XP.
By him going to jungle that early, it also allowed the Dazzle to rotate top. Like, if he were pressuring the gyro a lot more, then Dazzle can't leave his lane without it being super obvious or without his gyrocopter, like, just getting destroyed in lane. So that's one of the huge downsides of Iron Talon jungle early. And people are like, oh, now, yeah, why not Iron Talon jungle every single game? This is one of the reasons why.
S4 now, just on the side. Be able to find the level 6. And maybe with the presence of EGM, they can try and set something up mid. But at this stage, again, this is 7.5 minutes in. We're only seeing 1-1 on the board. Again, is this fine for both sides? Or was there a lineup that you were expecting to maybe be a little bit more proactive in trying to find?
I think Vega should have been a little bit stronger to lanes. That Dazzle rotation, as well as Mag going to the jungle, I think really set them back in the early game. Because I think they should have won mid. DP versus Brood should be fairly easy win for Death Prophet. And then Axe versus Brood, Axe should win that matchup, especially when Brood goes Spiderlings. And then in your bottom lane, you have Darkseer versus two relatively weak range heroes, Gyrocopter and Dazzle. So I think they should have won all three lanes. Right now, it's kind of a wash in all three lanes, which I think is a net negative for Vega.
I'll put on. Needs to be careful here. He's been dusted up. He can't climb his way up that cliff with the vision the Vega have. Trapped in the ring. The dunk down, slam down from Solo.
Oh, now Solo's getting really farmed. He already has Vanguard and he's almost halfway to his Blink Dagger. So.
And he's about to get a tier one as well.
Yeah, and Broodmother wasn't able to get her Midas in time. She did come into the phase boost before.
Bottom lane, S4 looking to go for the wraparound play. Eyes onto Mag, pops the split. Mag going to juke it out to the sidelines, and he may just be able to get himself out indeed. Vacuum up. They'll find the vision for the Cyclone, but TP's already coming through. They've got to be careful. Still moving in. Ghost coming out from no one. So Alliance will simply disengage. Mag falling low on the back lines. S4 getting himself out with the Earth Spirit.
That was a sick vacuum. If he had just TP'd, he would have been slain. But, yeah, with the vacuum, we're retreating under the T2 and buying time for his teammates. They did get Exorcism at the end of the day versus an Arcane Rune Primal Split.
No, I was going to say, yeah, kind of wasted ult. And this is giving the space for Arcane EGN to put some pressure on the tier 1 mid.
Still a nice maneuver by them. And Axe still closing in on his Blink Dagger relatively soon.
We'll see what's next for them here.
So maybe they can take a fight now with Primal Split up and Exorcism down. That'd be a pretty good timing for them. Unfortunately, Brewmaster will not have Blink by that time. But at the same time, Vega just kind of okay with the jungle Lifestealer. So how was the gold graph looking? 1,000 in favor of Vega, as expected with a jungler.
I mean, this is how much of an issue is this? The fact that Alliance have kind of left FN untouched in the jungle. Are they okay with this? Can they deal with a Lifestealer that's had this amount of free farm in the jungle?
Bane is exceptionally good at dealing with a Lifestealer. And Brewmaster is also exceptionally good at dealing with a Lifestealer. Lifestealer can't finish him off, and without Rage, you're just going to be thrown up in the air over and over and over again. So I think they have the tools, at least early. Once he starts hitting hard enough that he can just like kill people in like a matter of 1.5 seconds, then they might be under some pressure. But as of now, I think they're perfectly okay. They're making that same maneuver on bottom and deja vu.
Eyes onto Bulldog as well. He has been dusted. He's playing it nicely though, keeping himself away. And the dust halfway through his duration. Can he get himself out of this one? Heads up to the north and they haven't got vision on him there. He's outside of their peripheral range. Another dust expended. That one's not even going to clip him. So Bulldog, he'll be fine. And with the spiders on to Sherman the Slayer.
Do you want to feed the... Oh my goodness.
Ooh. It's close. Nearly giving up a fair bit of gold there to the DP. But with the pressure put on, you know, making a huge rotation come out from the side of Vega, unable Dyer's to kill Bulldog. Tier 1 down bottom is taken. There's a smoke up from Alliance. They're looking to wrap around and react to the reaction that Bulldog forced from Vega. Try and cut them off from the side here. Bulldog on the high ground. See what they can find. No one's actually... this invis room for no one could spell disaster.
That's awkward.
Yeah, it will indeed. Dispels the smoke. They know that the gig's up. And Alliance kind of wondering what was going on there. Midas now done on the Broodmother. Looking toward the Brewmaster. If S4 is able to get this tier 1 up to the top, he will have that Blink Dagger done. In fact, actually one more wave, and he will have the gold for the Blink. Primal Split at the ready, so if Vega come in to try and defend this, it's going to be a bit of a messy fight, so I imagine that at this point they just let Alliance get away with this tier 1.
Especially without the Blink Dagger on Axe.
Yeah.
He's pretty close. Not that close.
Dire's top tower is under attack. We have it. Free tower here for Alliance, really. Fortification will come through. Solo, he's going to make his way up there, but they're not going to commit anything else here to this defense, Vega. Extra tower for the guys, and Loader continue to farm up nicely on the gyrocopter. If you look at the net worth of this stage, 12 minutes in. Loader's at the top.
And Alliance make this move so often when there's a Broodmother. Five man, the enemy safe lane. Take down the tower, let Brute farm the jungle. And teams have yet to find a response to that.
And again, it just feels so strange, these games with Alliance versus Vega. We're 12 minutes in. There's only been three deaths. Very, very slow-paced games. The top lane, Arzon to Solo. They'd love to go for a bit of the heal bomb play, but Solo, let's see if he's wanting to come out. Oh, hello. Weave onto him. Heal bomb. Not going to do too much. So it's going to be fine. He's not going to fall to that one again. S4 and EGM, eyes on finishing off the tier 1 mid. It's incredibly low. Always Vega, just keeping the farm up. FN back into the jungle. Took the phase helmet, picked up the Blightstone. Look to try and get that Echo Saber online before turning up to the fights again. And obviously just having that Infest Bomb with Solo once he has the Blink Dagger complete, which he has Dyer's just picked up right now.
So they really got half smoke, of that. Though. They have a smoke. I don't see a smoke.
EGM and Alliance. S4. Just coming around here. Did spot out a mag by the secret shot. Roshan's up. Expect to see a side going for Roshan?
Vega could, but yeah. You want a team fight first, and you want to win a team fight without Exorcism, so you can commit it to Rosh. I don't think going to make this move without smoke. That is just...
This is awkward.
So clunky.
I mean, they might find us, but they know. You know, Alliance, they're being careful. They're backing off. Okay, he didn't get the memo. Straight in under the tier one. Jumping in, taking down the poor old Dazzle. No save for himself. Bulldog making the most of the space that's been given to him, doing a significant amount of damage to the tier two. TP coming in from FN. Alliance unable to really hit back without Ake. Lotus going to make his way along the river here. He has found no one. He's going to start to go with this. S4 jumps in a nice silence. And with the vacuum, the wall drops as well. Lodo and S4 in a bit of trouble. They get the primal split off. Lodo's got to get himself out of this one. Falling low as no one chases him down. Tries to go for a deny. He's not going to make it. They've lost Lodo. They will find Shoma in return. But not the trade that Alliance wanted there. No one trying to waltz himself back around. Maybe thinking of going for more. The nightmare and actually the stun kind of staggered there. But at the least, they'll just hold back the Death Prophet, allow the escape of the rest of the team. And at the same time, Broodmother, top lane, able to find a solo kill onto FN. So Alliance overall wants to be happy with that. It didn't look ideal at the start where they lose Loader, but Bulldog making sure that the trade does end up going the way of Alliance. And really eyes onto mid. EGM seeing if he sets him up. He's got a Fiend's Grip. He's going to blow it straight away, but Shoma's there. He's got the Glimpse. This might not be enough to save no one, though. S4 moving in. The Brain Sap, they'll do it. They'll take down the Death Prophet. Another kill for Alliance. And now, ready to get in for the push.
X is in this weird situation where he's constantly having to deal with the Brood, and
he's got a spider on him as well, just marking the position.
Yeah, he's their main initiator, though.
Yeah.
And they haven't been able to get clean jumps because he's constantly up there, and he's kind of forced to be up there. Darkseer maybe can do that, but he's the mech carrier, so they want him in a team fight. Death Prophet is far too vulnerable to be left out there alone, not even having that Yules yet, and no one might be the hero to pick on this game. Brewmaster is similar levels of farm to DP, but Brewmaster has his ultimate. He can generally get team fights A-OK.
He really can, as we've seen. I mean, Vega, they're going to go for a smoke. They want to try and catch someone out here. No Exorcism, though, for this fight. And we'll just come back up for Max. So let's see what Solo can find with the lead-in. Surged up. He's going to head up to the high ground. They've got the vision onto Loader. They'll catch him. Loader. They're going to be any kind of support, any kind of backup. Static Stones dropped as well. Wall as well. There's no escape for Loader. He's going to be a free kill for Vega. Alliance do anything to punish it. It doesn't look like they can, so they just have to let one go. So nice smoke from Vega. Successful kill onto the enemy carry. And they'll turn into a push as well onto the tier one here.
No primal split up for 20 seconds. Yep. Alliance should be aware that they do have a ward up that hill, or at least suspect as much. And don't really have any tower hitters.
Solo jumping in onto S4. S4 dragged down to the low ground by the vacuum, contained by the kinetic field, and Vega is on the retreat. Alliance, they don't really want to fight without Gyrocopter.
But no tower conversion. Yeah. That's a big kill, too. The Gyrocopter kill, you'd expect to be able to take down the tower after that because it's like half their team fight.
And this is a game as well where Bulldog, he's certainly finding the space. 7.8k net worth on your Broodmother. Minus Soaring Phase Boots, Echo Saber. Level 13 as well. And he's nearly finished off the tier 2 on the top lane. So Bulldog, he's having the game that he wants to.
Yeah, very consistent on the Broodmother.
I can't remember the last time we saw a bad performance from Bulldog on Brood. Actually, I think I can. I think they lost a game at the Major with it. But other than that, 90% of the time, Bulldog's going to have a great time. That's for certain. Vega looking to make a play again. FN inside a solo. Top lane, Bulldog just doing his best to really harass back no one. He wants to get himself in, finish off that tier 2. Very, very low as he has his eyes on it at the moment. Bulldog to move in. He just needs the creep wave to come in close enough to move the back door. And he can just set the spiders to finish it. And there we have it. Takes down the range creep. I'll take down the tower as well. More money to the pockets of Alliance. Brillo maintaining good control of the lane. And again, it's going to be the same build that we saw from S4 in the third game this morning against Fnatic. Picking up that Midas after the Blink Dagger. So he can continue to progress at a good rate. And as you pointed out before, just the importance of getting levels on the Brewmaster.
That was Cap.
That was Cap, actually. I thought that when I was saying it. I was like, hang on. That wasn't you, Ben.
That was not me.
That was not you, Ben. But you would agree with Cap? Levels are important for Brew.
Levels are important for many cores.
Yeah, that's true. So you're not, you wouldn't say you're a huge fan of this kind of late game Midas pick? Well, late-ish Midas pick.
Reliable gold.
Yeah?
Brew's not good at farming, that's for sure. So I think it really augments his biggest weakness, which is people avoiding fights and outwaiting or like waiting out your potency from your ultimate.
Yeah.
And you scale a bit better by getting auras. He loves his Vlads on the Brewmaster, as do most Brewmaster players, and it just makes you a lot more relevant going to the late game. It also opens up the Rojan potential for you. And the Midas just makes the game much less one-dimensional for Brewmaster, which is blink in, ult, and just do your thing.
GM nearly got the Alliance favorite, as you're talking about in game one. Four staff nearly done. I mean, this is going to be pretty brilliant against Vega's draft, especially for kind of the hype potential again. Keeping people away from the lifesteal.
I actually don't think it's that great this game.
You don't think against the lifesteal?
It's great against lifesteal, terrible against Kinetic Field, terrible against Axe.
Okay.
And not particularly good for Stark.
But I mean, is there anything you would have liked to see EGM maybe think about getting instead then? Of a four staff that would have been a Glimmer Cape, anything like that?
Glimmer Cape is really bad because they don't have that much magical damage and because they already have a gem on the axe.
Okay.
I would like to see Medallion so they can do Roche. Radiant's Dazzle is already on Medallion.
Okay.
What else on Bane? Yeah, I guess four staff's fine. Glimmer maybe so he can get the jump on some people.
But as you said, with the gem on axes.
Yeah.
I guess you can try and play
four
around.
Four staff
it.
Is fine.
Yeah. Bulldog as well, really racking up the gold here, 3.5k. What does he go for after the Echo Saber? I'm trying to think what he normally goes for when he goes the Echo Saber build. So sometimes he's picked up like the...
he varies it up a lot.
He does sometimes get the Bloodthorn. I've seen that before.
Orchid is great versus Lifesteal, right?
Yeah.
Vega heading to the Roche Pit. It will be immediately scattered out by the Satyr and all of Alliance headed towards the pit.
They've got to get themselves over here. If Loda can drop the combo... they've got a good chance.
It's more important that he gets the split off. This is the most important, crucial part of the fight.
They can definitely contest it. It's not the quickest attempt from Vega with the weave on no one. He's taking a few punches here from Roshan. So they can get themselves in, Alliance. Need to respond to this. They're waiting on Broodmother's spiders to scout out the situation. There's the cooldown. They're ready to move in. Spiders in as well. Can they steal this away from the guys? S4 comes in, but the Aegis has already been claimed. FM picks it up. Rages tries to walk it off. Static Storm, the wall's down as well. The Silence dropped out. It's caught out. Four of Alliance. Solo will still be taken down. FM fighting up against EGM. The brain cell. They'll burst down the Aegis. Siphon from no one. Keeping him alive. Bring in EGM low. He's going to go for the TP out. Is he going to make it? He is. They'll get EGM out of the fight. So one for one, and they were able to pop the Aegis. This is not bad for a fight the Alliance ran into after the back of losing the chance to get it, but this is bad for them. Limps back onto Loda, caught in the field. They'll lose the carry.
What a great silence coming out from no one. He silenced four heroes, and no grave under the brew. No split from the brew, and that is a lost fight. A nice arcane boost at the end to pick up that plus one with the man on Disruptor getting that glimpse, and that was a good fight by Vega. I'm not sure what Alliance were waiting for. They waited a little bit too long. I think it might have even been okay to just like blink an ult right outside the pit.
Rather than going into the center.
Yeah, they wanted to wait out to get the Prophet ultimate, but if you wait at the Prophet ultimate, you just give away Roche for free. And they were going for the Roche steal, but it was just a little bit too late. And more importantly, too predictable. Vega had the instant Yules onto him, into a Static Storm, into a Silence.
EGM of an Invis, this could be a good setup. He doesn't have Fiend's Grip.
That is a lot of spider wings. What on earth?
Yeah. Right, looks like they're not going to be feeling confident at going for that.
Staff into there.
He still wants to go. He's pinging it out. Nightmare. Where's the follow through? S4 with the blink clap. That's going to be the call. And here we have it. In with the spiders. She's using herself up to buy some time, but no one in a lot of trouble here. And they will get the kill. Alliance, now they're turning for more. Bulldog pots the BKB. Double kill for the man on the spider. Spider-Man indeed, second kill for Bulldog, continues to maintain his position at the top of the chart. 12k net worth on the Spider. It's been another brilliant game for the fans of the Arachnid. 7-7 at the moment between the two sides. A very similar pace to kind of game one that we saw. But again, this is something that you feel favors Alliance. You, yep. you feel Vega should be getting more done with the tools that, and the heroes they have in a game like this.
Yep. Yeah. I think they have better team fight, and yep. I think they have better gank with the Infest Bomb. They've also had a gem for a while, or they did have a gem. Where did the gem go?
Where did the gem go?
I don't know. Is that one chicken? Oh. Yep.
Yep.
That's on Bane.
Okay.
Radiant's AGM. Middle tower
well,
that, is under
that's
attack.
A big blow to them. Now Broodmother the kind of has a
gem
free
stealer.
Time. Gem Stealer. Is that a new hero?
Gem Stealer. That's good. See what the others do here in the mid lane. Push coming in from Vega. That's maybe in a position to defend. I guess Promise Split, someone caught him for 40 seconds.
I think
they'll let this one.
PKB on Brew. I think that's more important than the Flies at this point, just because they have so many tools to control them up.
Alright, popping the Exorcism as well. They're going to try and go for more. They will get the Glimpse back onto EGM. EGM, he'll force himself, but he's gone. Vega feeding down one, and with the Exorcism freshly popped, they can look to continue the push, try and take down Mortis with the Arcane Rune as well. This is go time ready for the Death Prophet. Alliance, they're going to have to hold the defenses with a man down. They may just end up having to let this tier 2 go. By the looks of it. And, oh, a Lifestealer. Actually there with the help of Solo, they'll kill off S4. So no S4, no EGM. Vega in a fantastic position to keep the momentum flowing. Oh, still a little bit too careful. I guess Exorcism coming off, they don't want to risk it. They're happy with the damage done. A Shiva's Guard now finished up. On no one as well. So their push is beginning to look very scary, very hard for Alliance to fight into as it scales up here. I believe is that the... Yeah, okay, finished SMY on top of the Dragon Lance for Loader. So Loader himself in a good point to fight 24 minutes into the game. But a good bit of play there from Vega.
Sets back Brew a lot. He will go for the Vlads.
Yeah.
As opposed to the BKB. X posing a lot of problems. I'm pretty surprised that they were able to kill the Brew so quickly. He does have Max Drunken Brawler.
Oh, let's see, okay, looks like the build from Bulldog. He's going to be picking up the AC this game for the team. Hyperstone done. Wires, EGM and Ake. Looking to move out. Maybe get a bit of a warding mission done here into the jungle of Vega. No, they're just going to hold back. They don't want to go blindly in on their own.
And they were just looking for a ward on the high ground.
Bordeaux leading the push in. It's going to be a smoke up from Alliance. So they can get the wraparound from behind. Primal Split's available. But immediately, scanned out by Vega. They know something's up. They know there's a movement from Alliance. And they are maybe going to try and counter it. They're going to head up to the high ground themselves. Maybe seeing if they can get the high ground jump onto the side. Bulldog's got to be careful. If they don't feel they can get the jump on the smoke, they might just move in onto the spider. S4 still hanging around with the Broodmother. And a blink down. EGM might find the opening for a Fiend's Grip. This is going to be laid down onto Solo. It's a nice weave as well. Laid down onto 3. Vega, they've got to be careful about fighting under the duration of this one. Now back off. Alliance unable to find anything without smoke, but at the same time, Vega unable to punish it with a kill.
Just being patient. Alliance... don't have BKB, so yeah. They're very scared about getting the jump with X. And I guess a Nightmare can maybe save them, but the Grave, very ineffective versus the X. So they really have to make sure that people don't die during the initial burst. And as you mentioned, the Force Staff might be their main tool, but all their solutions are just subpar. The Nightmare, not going to last very long versus the Rage Snakes. And they do scan up another smoke in the middle lane. Yeah, so I guess they might have to jump the X. But BKB is ideal, so that Lifestealer isn't able to
deep smoke as well. And they might still catch Loader. He's still come out. They pinged it out. Lines. They knew that something was amok. But Loader still walks into it. Vega find themselves one pick off. Can they find themselves anything more? Bulldog is around. Yeah, he'll keep himself out of harm's way.
This is not where you expect the gank to be.
I mean, it was a deep gank, that's for sure. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Vega off the back of it. The momentum with the creeps. They'll take down a tier 2. And Exorcism's up. Looks like it's going to be the indicator to try and go for more. Maybe try and force out the buyback from Loader. Still off the map for 30 seconds. See how they can hold this without the Gyrocopter. They're going to need to send their forces back. Exorcism ripping through the towers here. Fortification will buy some time. And with the weave down as well onto Vega, might be enough to slow them a little bit. No one seems to be insistent on standing strong. We'll finish off the tier 3. It looks like that'll be all though. Yeah, they're going to TP back out immediately after that one. But nonetheless, getting a tier 3 for free. Big kill onto Loda. Vegas certainly keeping the control on that. I mean, as we can see, up and down the net worth overall. This is, it's a very close game in terms of the numbers.
Seems as if Vega have much better control of the map right now.
Yeah.
Their team fight is superior because the Brewmaster is still very scared to jump in. If he dies due to a Static Storm or a Yule's in a Static Storm or even a Vacuum to interrupt it, I guess it's the most unlikely of the three. But they do have ways to stop him from casting his ultimate, and if they lose that, they would just lose everybody else at this point, with Broodmother being the only one that does have a BKB and Gyrocopter maybe wanting to farm that up at some point to deal with the vacuum wall. Or even the glimpse. Like, the glimpse is a big issue at this point. They've been able to get a lot of plus ones.
This could be one of the stepping stones for Alliance that they've been waiting for. AC done on Bulldog. A minute or so until Roshan's back up. So if they can get the Aegis and get the push on with the AC done, that's going to put them in a really good position. At the same time, though, Greaves picked up by Mag onto the Darks here. They are going to have the tools ready for the defense.
No one's getting pretty stacked.
Yep. Yeah, Octarine nearly done. Well, he's okay. He's still got a Mystic Staff to work through.
It's only 29 minutes, though.
Yes, yeah, it's a very good pace for the game.
So Tome on him, hoping, I guess, to get that level 16. Are they going to give it to him? Looks like it. And they will pick up his second gem, or maybe he just bought it for his teammate.
Let's see. Who gets the time? No one at the moment. Well, I say no one. Might be someone else. Anyway, it's going to go to Shoma. I'll give it to the Disruptor. Start to work his way towards level 11. He's very close as well to picking it up. Lion's actually in position to smoke. Maybe trying to bait out with the mild push from the Broodmother. Vega are around. This is a very risky time to take a fight, but it'll have big rewards if you can find a pick or two before Roshan's back up. Solo might be caught out here. They're actually going to jump in onto no one. Fiends grip him easy from EGM. The combo coming through. Oh, they brought him down. 60 seconds without this man. He went full in as well. No buyback available for no one. So Alliance, they'll just head up straight to the high ground. I don't know if they realize that this man he's got no money.
Where was his team? They expected like a blink vacuum perhaps to save him from the Fiend's Grip so that he can pop his heals.
They might even find more here. Shoma gets burst out. Vacuum wall onto 4. FN turning up, looking to take down a little bit of the Shallow Graves there. The dog, solo. Double kill for the Axe. Alliance suddenly, the aggression's been halted. They're being forced back by Vega, the 4-star Finn. Solo, can he get the lockdown? Yes, he can with the Surge 4. Gets the call off onto Bulldog. It's gonna be another dunk. Triple kill for the man on the Axe. And now he's looking for more. Eyes onto Ake. Solo is not done here. Vega, their jimmies have been rustled. And Ake, he'll be rustling in his grave. It's an ultra kill for Solo. What a defense there for a team that were lacking a Death Prophet and a Disruptor. The power of the Axe shown there. And just the uselessness of a Dazzle against those dunks.
They need BKBs. Vacuum wall into call with Ion Shell, Lifestealer beating on you. That was devastating.
Axe is done as well. I can't remember the last time we've seen an Axe. Yeah. Damn. The dunks are going to be real.
Yeah, we've mostly seen Blade Mouse come out.
Yeah.
I think Armor is pretty decent versus their lineup, too. Gotta get those dunks.
Absolutely, Vega.
That was 4-on-5. That was crazy.
Yeah. And this is such a great time to take a fight like that. As I said, going into that one, you're finding this position where Roshan's just back in the game. Aegis now on FN. Alliance certainly on the back foot now. This is a very, very fat Axe that's going to be running at them. Still, the farmer load has been good. He's maintaining that lead. Broomover as well. There's always the threat of this dong and 2.2k on the AC. It's going to be interesting to see what Bulldog goes for next. I mean, what do you think he does pick up as his next item? Is this where he gets the bots involved so he can start to go for those plays around the map?
I think you want another damage item.
Okay.
Bloodthorn is pretty decent. Very good against a Lifestealer, although he's mostly just going to pop out of Rage, or pop out of the Infest and then Rage immediately. I think Butterfly is pretty good versus their lineup. Increase your damage output a lot because you really need to kill people during your BKB. What else is there? Daedalus is kind of meh. Manta style is kind of meh.
I guess for damage, you just rather get the Bloodborne over the Daedalus if you want to go for some kind of crit and lock that. It's just an all round better item for the map.
Is the silence really that useful though? I don't know. I don't think the silence is that useful this game. Maybe on the axe.
Not against the Lifestealer, as you said.
The Lifestealer is usually infested.
I guess that's true. He's the one getting the jump on you. Yeah.
So he's going to pop it as soon as he gets Rage. And he has Aegis at this point. Darkseer has Grieve, so he just Grieves it off. Yeah, Death Prophet has Yules, he'll just Yules it off.
Disruptor, maybe.
Yeah, Disruptor is kind of chilly in the back, though.
Static Storm, yeah. It's a bit of an issue, of course, for the likes of...
Broodmother won't kill Disruptor.
I guess that's true. Yeah. He's dead.
He
can't silence the dead. Radiant's middle
tower
has fallen. There you go. Getting the Exorcism out, and time to push in. See what Alliance can do to stop this. It's a strong push. They need some kind of initiation. Fortification pop, EGM. We can see if we can get any kind of lock on. Vega a little bit timid here. They are respecting the punch back from Alliance. Just having to hang back and wait for the next creep wave to move in. But this is a lot of time of Exorcism essentially wasted on no one. So I don't even know if they're going to get away with a tier 3. Solo, he's got FN inside him. They are ready for the Lifestealer bomb to take place. They won't do it. Alliance hold. Still coming through. EGM slowly creeping forward. Axe down the sidelines. He is ready for the wombo. If Alliance do start to step too close for their own comfort. Alliance. I'm going to hold. We'll see BKB very shortly coming out for Loader as well. So they may want to be careful about fighting without that done. He's about a couple hundred gold away from having the BKB done.
I wonder if S4 is going to pick one up.
Yeah.
I guess alternatively, he could pick up Shiva's, I think?
Shiva's on the brew, yeah. I guess it would be nice. Are you against the 3 melee core?
There they go. Mass BKBs.
That's time to roll.
I think that's the primary reason why they lost the last fight, so
yep.
It's pretty good choice.
They are going all in, though. There's no buybacks, and there are two lanes which are, you know, exposed right up into the race. Fight. Top lanes doesn't even have a tier 3, so... A little bit risky here for Alliance if they do take a fight and lose these cores.
But if they win a team fight, Vega doesn't have a T3 in their mid. So it's kind of the same way I'd say for both teams. Like, if you buy back, you're not going to be able to get to the fight that quickly. No one has BOTs up on Vega. And, like, if you're Death Prophet, you die with Exorcism, your buyback's not particularly useful.
One thing that actually, there is a push coming in bottom. Loader, he does not have a slot for a TP. I guess an emergency boy sells as a killer picks up one, but he's not going to be able to react to the push down bottom if it comes in heavy from Vega.
I think it's really coming in heavy from Vega.
Load up. Where's your TP, son?
He can maybe bum one off EGM.
I guess they're gonna need him back here. Base in trouble. I mean, Alliance, they're still gonna push. Okay, they'll force Solo back, but no one in FN, they're sticking around. Power Split coming out from the sidelines. They try and cancel one TP. They will cancel Shaman the Slayers, but Exorcism coming through here, the heal bomb. They'll take down one buyback straight away from Disruptor, but they get away with this. Meanwhile, mid lane, Loader and EGM sticking around with Bulldog. And the middle is cleared out. So the trade will be done. Mid racks for the bottom racks. They actually kill no one. S4. King of the Power of the Spirit Siphon. He's got to back himself up. FN trying to move in as well. Still the fight contains mid. Is having going in. Loader with a BKB cooldown as well. Mag forced out. FN's turn back up. EGM go for the Fiend's Grip, but FN bites down onto the Bane. Kills him off. Loader's got to get himself out of this, but Solo, he's hot on the chase. Loader's making his way back to base. Can he get himself out of it? Solo's got a blink in a couple of seconds. Sif is going to be, he's going to try and cut him off for the sidelines. I think Loader's going to be lucky and we'll be able to get himself back to his friends. So a bit of an interesting play there from both sides. Vega go full in on the bottom. They claim the racks. Alliance go full in on the mid. They get a racks. So it actually gets the call off here. Back in S4, ready to hit back. No split though for 30 seconds. Mag jumping forward. I need to be careful. They're down a man for 10 seconds. Vega now in a position to push through. The waves come through as well. So, what's going on? Is it a favorable trade for Vega by the looks of it? Because they do get a trade and now they're still in the position of power with their current positioning on Alliance's half of the map.
Well, certainly helped that he did have an Arcane Rune at that point.
Yeah.
I think I think both teams were okay with it. Vega were like, yeah, we got more out of it. But Alliance were like, we're probably not as strong as teamfight, so if we trade evenly on objectives, we're doing okay. But as you mentioned, Vega continuing to go up. Exorcism just up in 3 seconds time.
Omen missile on the range creep. Bam.
Bam.
He got shown. Goodbye, Jim. 10-15. BKB done now on Axe. This is going to be a very nice cross against Loader. Just the magic damage output that he's kind of relying on at the moment. Hasn't really got that big DPS physical item picked up yet.
And it allows him not to get kited by the Brewmaster. That's your worst nightmare as an Axe. You blink in, you call, and then you get cycloned immediately. And then you don't have your blink or your call, and you're kind of just like stuck hoping you get hit.
This is panning out to be an interesting one. This state of the game, as we can see, Vega, they do have the overall lead net worth, but 5k 38 minutes in, it's nothing that can't be turned around with one good successful team fight for Alliance. Roshan, still a bit of a time before we'll see that one come back up, and it's smoked up from Alliance. They want to try and get something done with the primal split, look for a jump towards the mid lane. Let's see if they are going to be able to do this. They're fighting into all the ults of Vega, everything ready for the side of the Dire. Bulldog positioning himself and trying to get vision for the team. It's night time. Vision is limited. Shiva's guard now used. Weave's there. They know what's up. Alliance, they just need to close the gap. They need to get S4M with a blink clap. But already, Vega reacting. Backing up, keeping themselves away from the side. And it looks like Alliance won't find anything with the smoke. So it's going to be Vega themselves. The double back smoke. Now wanting to take advantage of the fact that they know that Alliance were just in a position trying to look for some action. Maybe Vega can catch them off guard now. They'll make the deep movement over the river. They're going to head straight towards the top lane. They're going to cut past the secret shop. They are going to find people here. Bulldog on the high ground, actually dispelling some of these smokes. They need to be careful here, Alliance. They could get caught apart. Eyes onto Ake. Ake is going to be the one in trouble. At the same time, they try and go onto Loader. Loader pops the BK build. Will still be caught up by the call. They'll cancel Ake's TP with a vacuum. Back towards Loader. The dunk down's there, and two are dead. Solo finding the big cool kills.
Did he walk back? Did he? Wow, did he just get owned by the call that
bad? Vega, they have managed to find themselves another set of racks. Yeah, fortification and pieback, no messing here for Alliance. They're very close to being megged with their last set, two sets of racks being exposed. Bulldog, it's gone to FN. FN, hold the rage, ready to fight back. There we go, S4 jumps in with the BKB, make sure he gets the split off. Already, Lifestealer jumps in the mag, tries to get himself out. They've got the Cyclone to control, no one. But Loader, Bulldog gonna get dunked. Loader, he's gotta run, he's gotta hide. This is a dieback if he goes down here. They've gotta keep this man safe. Bulldog will buy back. They'll allow Loader the space to move back. And a Fiend's grip onto no one. Can they be bringing this man down? Bulldog, Dunge Chomp, the Exorcism Ghost healing him up. They can't kill no one for the time being. And now the Static Storm traps up Bulldog. He's caught S4 as well. Solo with the spins. He's going to have the dunks. There's one, there's two. Solo cleaning up Alliance. Vega forcing them back to the base here. Can Alliance hold at this point? Fight back on Bulldog. He's dead for 100 seconds. EGM, Nightmare onto Solo, they need to find kills, but the Nightmare's gone back the way of Loader. Again, they're toggling it here, S4 jumping in with the three-man clap, the cooldown, the Rocket Barrage is there. They've taken down Solo, eyes towards no one as well. Alliance, they should be able to clean up the Death Prophet here. A second kill on the defense, but it's a costly one. Alliance have been mega-creeped, but this is a position that we've been used to seeing Alliance get in time and time again, and they have shown us that they can turn around games at this stage, but it's going to be incredibly hard, Ben. Vega are going to be very, very happy with the way that this has gone.
Yeah, he's going to need a rapier to turn this one around. And we already see the anti-megas coming out. Bane with the Maelstrom pickup. And they are prepping for the long one. But seemingly bleak outlook for Alliance.
Yeah.
Because Vega just keep on winning teamfight after teamfight. Seems like Lifestealer is still strong in this patch after all. And the way they want to deal with Alliance's greed is by having greedy heroes of their own with this jungle axe just destroying them.
I'm actually going to be Loader just going for the bots as well. So it looks like they're going to just try and get the rest of the team pushing down the mid lane. Loader's going to do his best to clear out some of the mechas, and then they're going to maybe TP in. Just go full in for the win. They've cleaned out the mid lane racks. At this stage, Alliance, if they want to go in, they've got to go for just an all-out push surely onto the base.
It seems that way. But then how do they deal with just like an axe blinking with BKB and then a rage Lifestealer popping out? Maybe like a really good Fiend's Grip can come out and EGM can save the day, but that seems pretty unlikely because Darkseer can just interrupt that, and their team fight is just really strong from Vega right now. Exorcism to force Alliance to come to them. They have tools to deal with the Brewmaster ultimate, and more importantly, the Axe Lifestealer combo just immediately kills one of Alliance's hero at the start of the fight. And it looks like they're trying to do a different variant of the combo with a newly acquired Hexenblade.
And Vega, of course, taking Roshan when the game is in this kind of space. You've already got the Megas. It's very unlikely that Alliance can do anything to stop this. They're going to have to let this one go. It's looking rocky, Ben. It's looking like we are on the verge of seeing a game free from this series.
Absolutely.
Vega really stepped it up here in game two. We said they needed to change it up. They've done exactly that. And it's still not the quickest of starts. But now a very, very strong, powerful force that Vega have managed to build up. And Alliance just unable to contain it, control it.
So the answer was to take it slower by having a jungle.
I guess so. The jungle largely has certainly worked out here. Looking for the catch on the side, won't quite get it. Mag, making a beeline for Bulldog. Does have that side, we've got to remember, on the Darkseer as well.
Worried about a four staff. Without the axes, the four staff will own that initiation. Unless you have Abyssal, which he does not.
It's Bloodthorn on Bulldog. He's gone all in. Such a hard fight for Alliance, though. Relying almost for sure on Vega just making a mess up. But Vega, they've not been messing up this game. They've been playing really tight Dota.
So what do they really need? Like a full duration grip on a very important hero? Probably no one.
It's a very hard team to get the potential to do that. So many ways of interrupting EGN's grip. It's on the Bulldog, so they're trying to jump in. Actually going to miss the call here. FF's jumped out. BKBs are there. The Primal Spirit's already out. They'll turn towards solo. Bulldog has actually Bloodthorned a creep here. Bit of a misplay. They'll turn towards no one. Can they kill this Death Prophet? The Octarina Hill, is it going to be enough? Pops the cheek. Could they kill it? I don't think they can. They can't. And now the turnaround. Darkseer, Wall Vacuum. They've found two. They've found three. Alliance, they're crumbling. And Vega, they've done it. They'll take this series to a game three. Alliance just messing up a little bit too much. And Vega are just playing really well at the end of the day. And as you said, the jungle lifestealer, it worked perfectly. Solo's axe pickup, it was great this game. And Loda, he never really got the damage that he needed to deal with Vega's aggression.
And Vega comboed really well. The Darkseer axe combo that we saw like three or four times that kind of sealed the deal for them in that mid fight, that was the real game winner for Vega. And I think some question needs to be asked about whether or not they should commit for the Midases or goal in the team fight. But this is what happens with the Brood pick. You're kind of stuck in this weird place where your early laning phase is supposed to be great, but